Gun, Michael Cole, and Kevin Kelly. It's going to be Tennessee versus Texas. Not a great welcome for the King and Company. Because we're in Texas. First time that the King ever agreed that the head was this past week on Raw, when the head firmly believes that Brian Christopher is not the son of the King.
I agree with the head too.
Figures, you would agree with a mindless mannequin head.
Well, I mean, I agree with the statement that
you have a lot in common with this mindless mannequin head, but that's another story for another time.
Yep.
Here we go now. Listen to the reaction for this group. Batten down the hatches. The party sticks to start. Up with too much having to take on Al Snow in the head. How focused are they going to be having to deal with Bradshaw, Terry Funk, and Dustin Reynolds? This match is going to be wild.
Yeah, Al Snow in the head against too much at the King of the Ring. Al Snow wins. He gets a meeting with McMahon. He loses. See you later. And I can't wait to see Terry Funk and Jerry the King Lawler in the ring if they get it on one-on-one here.
One of the greatest matches ever took place back a few years ago. One of my first experiences with wrestling was Terry Funk one-on-one with Jerry the King Lawler, and certainly historians know both men are legends in the sport.
And the King telling us backstage it's been a while since he's been in the ring with Terry Funk.
Oh, he's talking all kinds of smack about Terry Funk to me. He says he's going to knock him out, he's going to break the old man's teeth, he's going to do everything to him in this matchup. We'll see if any of it comes true.
I'll tell you what, I can't wait to see the big Texan Bradshaw in the ring either, as Dustin now hooks up with a two-hot Scott Taylor. Side headlock now. Don't forget, folks, King of the Ring this Sunday, live exclusively on pay-per-view, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. The Igloo in Pittsburgh is sold out. Only one way to see it, on pay-per-view.
Oh, my! And the best seat in the house is in the Igloo, but the next best seat is right there in your easy chair. All the comforts of home there, the pay-per-view, and nobody does pay-per-view like the World Wrestling Federation.
Dustin, of course, with a large weight advantage over Scott Taylor, whips him into the ropes. Taylor with a leapfrog over top and catches him with a boot to the midsection. Setting him up now, but here's Dustin again and tosses him away like a sack of potatoes.
Dustin has dropped about 15 pounds, as a matter of fact, and he's in the best shape he's ever been since he's come to the World Wrestling Federation. Bradshaw's in, and I think Taylor's attitude has just about changed.
Oh, my! Attitude adjustment right there by Bradshaw. Big boot to the head. Taylor wants to crawl out of the ring. He's going nowhere.
King was smart enough to get out of there. Christopher took a shot, and Lawler was heading for higher ground.
And Bradshaw, 300-pounder, with Taylor in the corner. Speaking of weight advantages, Taylor weighs in at 214. This is a mismatch. Oh, my! It's Scott Taylor in La La Land.
I don't think there's anybody tougher in the World Wrestling Federation as far as being able to deliver a shot, making each shot mean something. There is no such thing as an easy match with Bradshaw.
I'll tell you, as Christopher now goes over onto the apron of the ring, Bradshaw hammering away, trying to rake the eyes of the big Texan. Tell you what.
Well, it only stopped him for a second, Michael. Look at this. Right back up.
Suplex from the second row. Oh, my. It's Scott Taylor trying to make a tag, and he does. And here comes Brian Christopher. Folks, another match has been added to King of the Ring. X-Pac versus Owen Hart. Revenge on the minds of both men.
We saw it in the Kaboom of the Week a little earlier on, Michael. X-Pac with the chair shot to the back of Owen Hart's head left Owen needing 7 staples to close that wound. Owen Hart is railing hot at X-Pac, and this match was signed earlier in the week based on the animosity that's built up between these two stars.
What a forearm by Brett. the 53-year-old. And he wants Lawler. He wants the King.
He said, I'm calling out your old man.
And the crowd wants the King in there as well.
It's his alleged old man. You tell that to Terry Funk, I dare you.
And here's the King now.
I double dare you. Get up there.
So it'll be the King and Funk. Been a while since we've seen this matchup. And Terry Funk with some choice words for the King. And here he goes now. And the King with a big right hand. Oh, he's setting him up here.
Wait a minute. King's going to end this one right here.
The move the King made famous. The patented pile driver. And the fans don't like it here in Texas.
I'm a little surprised Lawler didn't go for the cover. He just delivered the coup de grace there to the hardcore legend.
And Lawler's asking for another one.
Come on. Was banned in just about every state of the union. The pile driver, of course, legal here in the World Wrestling Federation, has just floored Terry Funk for a second time.
Right hand by the King. Now in control of his Texas legend. A third right hand.
The state of Tennessee representatives now with the advantage.
Oh, my. The King outside the ring, and Terry Funk's going out after it.
You never.
Giving away $2 million in honor of
the believe before the break, you put me in front of you to protect you from a fucking law.
You're a very brave man. You couldn't wait to jump in.
I mean, you're twice as big as I am.
Well, that's not saying much.
And here's Terry Funk now hammering away on a 260. And Teddy Jerry Sutner to the DDT.
Fans will be chanting head Pittsburgh.
Here's the cover on Chris the Burning kick out.
Al Snow in the head, it's a handicap match, Michael Cole. Let's not talk about it any other way. Al is going to have to basically fight both members of Too Much by himself because the head is not going to be able to help Al Snow, no matter what Al might think of them, as he calls them.
King of the Ring, pay-per-view. Terry Funk now turning the tables a little bit on the King.
It's like being run down by your own car.
And the King crawling in the corner, and here comes Scott Taylor.
Brian kind of gave him the short arm of the tag, and he looked too anxious to get back in.
Yeah, Brian not trying to help Daddy out there.
There you go.
I mean,
see,
sorry,
just
threw
the point.
And
look at this.
Daddy.
We finally made a breakthrough, folks.
Daddy. Dustin Reynolds off the ropes now. And there's Christopher from behind. And Taylor takes advantage with a big right hand. Follows it up with a boot to the back of the head.
Some of the outstanding teamwork that Too Much is going to be displaying and have to take advantage of. When they take on Al Snow in the head this Sunday night, live on pay-per-view at the King of the Ring.
You think you'll have Al Snow in the head on a backstage at King of the Ring?
Well, we'll see if we can get a coherent thought out of him. But, folks, you can order backstage at King of the Ring. WWF.com is our website. Order down
to the pay-per-view. You get to hear all your favorite WWF superstars and even Kevin Kelly.
We're going to... What is that supposed to mean? We're going to have the Attitude Cam floating around backstage. We're going to be the eyes and ears of everything happening behind the scenes and King of the Ring.
Oh! Christopher launched into the turnbuckle. Desperation move by Dustin Reynolds.
Well, I say this match between the state of Texas and Tennessee is at a crossroads right now.
Inverted atomic drop down. And here Dustin makes the tag, and here comes Bradshaw.
Oh!
What a boot. King. Christopher off the ropes now. Big elbow by Bradshaw. Look at Taylor on the top rope.
Well,
Bradshaw just grabbed him in midair.
Oh, man.
What strength in the following slam. Bradshaw just caught 214 pounds in midair.
Hooking horns. Here we go.
Setting him up. Oh. And here's the cover now on Christopher. Somehow.
Christopher.
No. He popped out somehow.
I thought it was all.
Drop. And the King landed in his left thumb's lap.
pretzel.
And now Bradshaw left in the ring with Christopher.
Oh, this is bad if you're Brian Christopher.
Look out now. Bradshaw. There it is. The clothesline from hell. It's over. Texas wins. So a big victory for Texas, folks. Plenty of action still to come on Shotgun when we come back.
Talk about it, and I'm going to give you my reason why. I think this Sunday night we could crown a new World Wrestling Federation champion in the form of Kane.